the greatest. Yeah, yeah. You can be the best. Yeah, yeah. You can be the greatest. Yeah, you can be the best. Yes. Oh, no contest.
Be a champion.
What's it like to be a slugger?
What's it like to be a slugger?
I know you love me. This is Ben. He's the greatest ball player around. Greatest ball player around.
Greatest ball player around.
You are the greatest ball player around. That's what I want you to tell yourself, Ben. Look at you holding your trophy from Little League T-ball. This is my first time doing a narration. I'm going to try to run this all the way through. That's you and your brother back in your Aunt Either days, sitting in my car. I'm going to try to run through this, just letting it run with the way I have the pitchers in order. But you have a TOC game coming up, and you and I were on the phone yesterday, and you were telling me about people talking about... That's going to be you, man. You got to picture yourself there. 2017, UCLA. You guys are going to be the all-stars. You're going to take it. Tournament of Champions. You and your brother are definitely all-stars. My point is this. Don't let anybody else tell you to be scared or to be worried because the other team has a pitcher that pitches 70 miles an hour or they hit 6 home runs. That's no big deal, man. It doesn't matter who they were playing at that point in time. They weren't playing you, the UCLA Bruins. I want to roll into the Red Sox here. Because the Red Sox, as you know, is Daddy's team. As far as I'm concerned, it should be America's team. Because it is Red Sox Nation. My point is this. I took you to a Red Sox game, your mom and I. That was your first major league game because I love the Red Sox. They're my champions when it comes to a major league baseball team. Just like you and your brother are my champions now. Okay? So, with that being said, I really want you to ignore anything that you hear about the other team. Because... there was a curse on the Red Sox for apparently 86 years. You can read about it here. Curse of the Bambino. And the Red Sox didn't win a World Series for 86 years. And in 2004, they broke that curse. And, they had to take the Yankees out to get there. And the Yankees and the Red Sox have always been rivals. It's a love-hate relationship. It is what it is, you know. They're right there next to each other. And just so you know, your daddy's a Red Sox fan because I was born in that whole New England area. I don't want to say where. Of course, you and I can talk about it and you'll know. But so the Red Sox, to me, that's my team. And baseball's a huge thing in our family, son. As you'll see coming up in this video here, you'll see some pictures at Williamsport. And your great-grandfather, my grandpa, he was born and raised in Williamsport, Pennsylvania. You can't get anything closer to that. That was your great-grandfather. He was born in Williamsport. Look, really quick, this is the team from 2011. I put that on there for you, Bradley. But, Ben, there was a team of the Red Sox there in 2007. As you can see, that ring. Look at that ring. I think that's the best-looking ring, too, is 2007. But they won the series in 2007, the year you were born, so I put the roster on there. My point is this. You have a lineage when it comes to Little League Baseball. And I can't tell you how many times I've toured that museum there. At the field, I can't tell you how many hot summer days Grandpa Hall walked around with me, and we just had some good times there. My goal in making all of this and just narrating and just wanting to be there with you, but I can't, so I want to put this video together. It's just to tell you that it's all about having fun. And as long as you go out there and you put that glove on and you put that bat in your hand and you throw that ball with the intention of, I'm here to have the best time possible, you and your team are going to find yourself standing in that field one day. That's the field where Little League has their World Series. And then you're going to be able to carry a flag like that. And then one day you're going to be able to play for a team like that. Because I believe in you. I will always believe in you. And I want you to know that you, Ben, and my little Bradley coming up here, you guys mean more to me than anything. And you two are champions. And as long as you understand that you're brothers for life, okay, there's nothing that's going to hold you back. So, Ben, ignore the rumors about the pitcher pitching 70 miles an hour. I bet you can hit an 85 mile an hour fastball, so don't even worry about it. Tell him to pitch you a 76 mile an hour fastball, because that's the year your dad was born. I love you, boys. Here are some baseball quotes from some real good people. Michael Jordan played baseball a little bit. But read these quotes, Ben, and take them to heart. I really love you, boys. I miss you. Thank you for watching this. Kick some butt. Kick some butt. I love you, Ben. Have some fun. You can run the